around my story.
I tell myself, ignore it. It's getting closer. Just ignore it. But it gets even closer. I tell myself, act natural, like you see nothing. But then it passes right by me. I take a deep breath. There's another one, but it's far away from me. Don't worry, I'm as lost as you are. Excuse me, your order? The cashier asks me. Hurry up, you're holding up the line, says the man behind me. I quickly order a cheeseburger with Coke and take the receipt. That was so tense. See, the thing is, I've been able to see ghosts for a long time. It all started when I was a kid. I was so scared, and I told my parents, but they didn't believe me. I was quite the storyteller back then too. Now let's go back to the restaurant. I get my meal and sit back at my place. I see ghosts, wandering aimlessly. How interesting, right? Wrong. I notice a few girls sitting next to me. I recognize one of them, Jennifer from my class. She is adored by everyone. I find her quite annoying. I think she senses me looking and glances at me. I quickly look away. I prefer being alone over being a clown. It's starting to get dark. As I walk home, I take a few snaps with my camera along the way. Trees, flowers, sky, streets, cars, houses, or anything beautiful that catches my eye. It's like capturing the moment at the right time and from the perfect angle. The street in autumn looks amazing. The mix of red, yellow, and orange is dazzling. It's my favorite time of the year. There are a few people here and there. So are the ghosts. I used to have a hard time figuring out if a certain person is alive or is a ghost. They all just seemed so similar to me. As I'm walking, wrapped up in my thoughts, I see a guy standing near a tree, a few steps away. He's staring at the leaves. At that moment, he looks picture perfect. He's tall, dark messy hair, and curious eyes. He looks like he's in a trance, deep in thought. The setting sun's light graces him, at the right angles. Alas, I couldn't help but want to try to capture this image. He notices someone staring at him, and he looks at me. Embarrassed, I just nervously wave my hand and say sorry. He looks around to see if I was talking to someone else. Feeling awkward, I turn and go on my way. But he's coming towards me now. And then I watch as a woman with a stroller passes by, and he goes right through her. That's when I realize I'd made a huge mistake. He keeps walking toward me, confusion on his face. I ignore him and keep walking. This is what I meant by not being able to tell the difference sometimes. "Hey, wait!" he yells, but I pay him no attention. This is why I avoid them. As soon as they notice I could see them, they either won't leave me alone or want me to do something for them, which is quite a hassle. Plus, what if some of them try to hurt me? As I keep walking, he runs up in front of me. "You can see me, right?" he says. I ignore his words and walk right through him. Whenever I make these types of mistakes of revealing myself, I make them think they misunderstood. And then they leave. "I know you can see me," he says, and keeps following me. Now he's walking right beside me. I keep ignoring him. "Why are you pretending?" he asks. He keeps trying to get me to talk all the way to my house. When is he gonna leave? I wonder as I enter my home. I groan internally as he follows me inside too. He smirks. "I know you can see me. Ignore me all you want. I am gonna make you talk to me," he says as he follows me to the kitchen. This is getting frustrating. At night, when I try to sleep, it feels so unbearable. He's sitting right in the corner of my room. He still hasn't left. He must have known I can't fall asleep as he starts humming. It's all to annoy me so I would acknowledge him. Resist. Resist it. I keep telling myself. Don't snap. He wants you to do that. Don't do it. I take a deep breath and calm myself. After that, I try my hardest to sleep while he annoys me all night long. I didn't even get a wink of sleep. I pat myself on the back for keeping it all together all night. Looking at the mirror, I look like a zombie. He laughs, much to my irritation. You look terrible. I'm honestly impressed by your patience and endurance, he says. I sigh. I was so nervous for today's presentation I couldn't sleep at all, I say to myself. He simply rolls his eyes. Later, he follows me to school. He noticed how I avoid confrontation with other ghosts. Why do you avoid them? With your ability, you could help them, he says as I take my seat in the class. No way. Like I said, it's such a hassle to do all of that. It's not my job. He then sits on top of my desk, one leg on top of the other. Annoying. So, Elizabeth, I see you have no friends. You're lonely. That's not good. You should learn to make friends. He laughs. I simply take out a book and read. I won't let him get on my nerves. He then leans towards my face. I keep my eyes on the book. He smirks. You're a sad little person. Then gets up and leaves the classroom. I sigh in relief. Finally he's gone. At lunchtime, I head to the cafeteria. While I'm eating, I suddenly spot him from the corner of my eye. He's just goofing around, making faces at people and wandering around through them. Seeing him like this makes me giggle. I made you laugh. He's right beside me all of a sudden. I was just about to turn towards him when I restrained myself. Seriously, just drop it. I already know you can see me. Don't worry, I'll keep it a secret. I hear him say, I don't want to. Bracing myself, I only glance at him. When he sees that I'm looking at him, he smirks. So, ready to talk now? He says, he's the most frustrating ghost I've met so far. Usually when I make a mistake and they follow me, they only stay for a little while before giving up. But this guy